Welcome back to Upfront. Recalls aside, we'll be looking at several of Wisconsin's key congressional races in the months ahead. Is it possible that the first congressional district will have a more competitive race than we've seen in many years? Republican Congressman Paul Ryan, the House Budget Committee chairman, will face Democrat Rob Zerban, a small businessman and county supervisor from Kenosha. Rob Zerban joins us today on Upfront. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Thank you for the invitation, Mike.
I want to get a better understanding of why you think you will succeed where others have failed. There's not really been a close competitive contest in that district in more than a decade. Mm-hmm. And Paul Ryan, because of his stature in the party and his resources, is going to be a tough guy to take down. Mm-hmm. Why do you think you're going to be able to do that?
Well, I think that Congressman Ryan has made himself extremely vulnerable with his proposal to privatize Medicare and Social Security. And in the past races, you know, Paul Ryan's never seen a challenger quite like myself. You know, I'm a small businessman, somebody who's employed people and provided excellent wages and benefits, and has a story that a lot of people in the first congressional district can relate to. And I think
in what sense?
Well, I lived my version of the American dream. You know, I grew up eating government cheese and getting free lunch and milk at school. And I was only able to succeed in life because our government made a modest investment in me, helping me get an education with Pell Grants and Stafford Loans. And I understand intimately why these programs need to exist for future generations of Americans to have the same economic opportunity I had as a small business owner and live that dream. So I look at what Congressman Ryan's proposing and say, these are not the values of the first congressional district. You know, we didn't send him to Washington to privatize Medicare and get rid of Pell Grants and Stafford Loans, things that help people have that chance to succeed.
Paul Ryan will argue, and I'm sure you've heard this many times, that this nation faces a debt crisis, and that if we don't get serious about addressing mm-hmm. some of our big problems, including what we do about Medicare, sure. These programs will not exist for future generations, at least not in a way that we recognize. Is he wrong when he says we need immediate action?
Well, I don't think anybody disputes the fact that we need to address our long-term debt problem and that we need to address our deficit spending. But I think we vary differently on how we would go about addressing it. You know, personally, I feel we need to go back and renegotiate things like Medicare Part D, which was a big gift to Big Pharma, where the taxpayers and the American people weren't the winner in that situation, but the industry was. And, you know, it's the largest expansion we saw of Medicare, and it was the most expensive expansion we've seen of Medicare. And it's one where we gave up the fundamental right for the federal government to negotiate for the price of prescription drugs. You know, and as a small business owner, somebody who had to negotiate for the things I needed to do to conduct business, this was not a common sense approach to how we handle taxpayers' dollars. So we need to go back and, you know, it's programs like that that have made these programs expensive and have added to the debt, and we need to go back and renegotiate these things and make those pharmaceutical companies compete against each other for the business of the federal government.
Is Medicare the issue, or is that more important, for example, than the economic interests of your district, which has felt, has had some struggles over the last few years?
Absolutely. And, you know, we've seen 14 years of Paul Ryan as the representative in the first congressional district and the bad choices that he's made. You know, he's not fought for investment in infrastructure. We have crumbling bridges and roads that need to be repaired. And that would go a long way to making bringing in a lot of jobs back into the first congressional district. And those are the kind of things that I would advocate for.
I wanted to ask you about something I read in an interview you did with Roll Call, the Capitol Hill newspaper, and it said that at one time in your life, in the not-too-distant past, you actually identified as a Republican. What mm-hmm. happened to change you?
Well, you have to put it in context. I was in high school. I actually had my picture taken with Phil Crane.
The Illinois
congressman. Mm-hmm. And for me, it was an anti-corruption stance. It was the time when Dan Rostenkowski was going to jail for the postage stamp scandal, if you remember that.
I do.
And so I looked at the things that were happening, and I thought, there's too much power in one party's hands, and this is what happens, and there's corruption can take place. So, you know, as we saw with Jack Abramoff, I've always been a person who's been for transparent government, fair government, and wanted to make sure that the people were not being taken advantage of, and that clearly was the case in that situation. So for me, it was an anti-corruption stance.
And so that was many years ago. You're saying that...
Correct. I was in high school at the time.
Okay, and in recent years, you've been a diehard Democrat?
That took place during the Clinton administration. You know, as my views of the world and my understanding of public policy changed, I was supportive of President Clinton and his agenda, and we saw how wonderful the economy grew, and we had, you know, budget surpluses at that time.
Rob Zerban, who is the Democratic candidate in the 1st Congressional District. Thanks very much for your time today. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Mike.
And next, the state budget. Balance or not? And be sure to check out Upfront on Facebook.